concert, this evening we gather as one family to enjoy different choirs, different passages from the Bible, I learned that there is a secret of a good reading or good sermon. The secret is to have a good beginning and a good ending, and there is one more secret. The two have to be close together as possible. So, I promise to not talk too long, and welcome everybody. Enjoy this time here as we listen to our beautiful choirs. And right after this service, this concert, we invite everybody downstairs for a coffee and snacks. Thank you.
Thank you. readings from Isaiah 11, verses 1 to 6. A shoot shall come out from the stock of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall be.
Thank you. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor, David."
Thank you.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands and cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you.
there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over the flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Don't be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you today is born this day, the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom his favor rests."
Mercy, God of God. When the angels have left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
Thank you.
In the beginning was the Word,
and the Word was with God,
and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through Him, and without Him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in Him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through Him. Yet the world did not know Him. He came to what was His own, and His own people did not accept Him. But to all who received Him, who believed in His name, He gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. We have seen His glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Thank you.
you all truly a very Merry Christmas. Let us pray. Gracious God, you gave us Christ, the Son, to save us. As you sent the one foretold, send us now with good news for all people. Let the gladness of this feast have no end, as we share with others the joy that fills us. And now may Christ, who by his incarnation has filled each of us with grace and truth, give each of you peace this Christmas and always. And may the Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. One more quick invitation. Sorry, I forgot that one. On Tuesday night, this coming week at Grace Church, there will be a Blue Christmas or a Darkest Night celebration. For those people who find this time of the year a more difficult time to be around or to be with others, it's a time to think about the darkness in your life as well as the light that comes through Christ. And that'll be at 7 o'clock at Grace Church. Go now in the glory of God the highest. Share the gift.